Yo, should be glasses without glasses. How it should go?
Is it reflecting?
Oh, it's good. So this is the first time I'm shooting at evening hours. The budgies are still not asleep. And I cannot be loud at night, so probably I have to adjust with another audio source or something. Yeah, so just remember a good story about a good versus bad teacher, or good versus bad student as well. So I remember most of my life I was, you can say, very repulsive towards authoritative kind of stuff. So anything authoritative, something a rebellious attitude used to come. So therefore, most of my life I had very toxic relationship with my teachers, because the reason is you need a liberty to offend anyone when you are learning something. And if that liberty is not there, because some of your questions, instead of hitting the subject, they hit the person's ego. If you get some examples, then you'll be able to understand what I did say and what I'm going to say. Currently, I cannot give you examples on tip of my finger, but like when you're exploring some subjects, your curious mind keeps on asking some kind of questions which are probably not matching, or they are questioning the authoritative person to reanalyze his own thinking about that subject. Probably he or she might have their own biases, and they have to rethink on that biases, and that makes them very angry. So like a teacher, howsoever ideal we think of, is a human person, and so therefore these biases definitely occur. And so therefore all my life I had very, what to say, toxic relationship with my teachers. And once we overcome that toxic barriers, there was a part where that learning began. And I did learn a lot. So sometimes I feel that was I a bad student, or sometimes I feel that was that a bad teacher. So there is a small story. What happened was, while I was studying in my engineering 2007 to 11, yeah, so it is a story in between my first and second year. Love this fellow, Dr. Don Tulwar. He had a very different idea of how the mass should behave. So once we went to a class where we shouldn't be present, and then he just called me and said, like, Tapish, anything done in mass is not a crime. So like that made me re-question all the judgments which happened before, and like that rule does not apply everywhere. I know now, but like at that particular time he wanted to say that if everyone is bunking the class, you should bunk the class as well. You don't have to be the ideal student and go and attend the class when even teacher is not sometimes not interested to teach as well. So like that kind of liberty should be there. So if you're bunking in mass bunk is not counted as a crime. So that kind of idea was there. And along with that, there was another professor, same year, Professor Borikar. His story is completely the reason I'm making this video. So what happened was, we followed the Borikar's theory and we did a mass bunk. And we were across the college, means Pradeshini Institute of Engineering Technology. We actually came out of the college. We were sitting in a tea stall kind of stuff. And there was a studious guy named Akshay Karkare. He came on a bike, and that bike did not belong to him because we used to pick and drop him. So like he came on a bike and he said that the professor Borika sir is calling you, Devendra Borika. Yeah. And he was like, how did he know that we are here? So, like, he knows stuff, so he knew where we are, where, after bunking. And there was a practical class, physical chemistry or applied, some kind of chemistry class that we bunked. So he called us back, and then slowly, because we were the, we named our group as a six Stiflers, inspired from the movie American Pie. That time it was very famous, so we named our group as six Stiflers. So if you catch on to Stiflers, Stiflers know where other people's hiding out where. So like, we had to then go and call each and every person, and that bike was given to Akshay by the professor, like, take my bike and bring those students back in. So we came back in inside the college, and then the professor was like extremely calm, and he just used very polite words, saying that I think I'm not a good teacher. If I'm a good teacher, then I won't be teaching in this university. And we were laughing at that point, like we know the quality of our education at that Nagpur University, in that Priyadarshini Institute of Engineering Technology. It's not good. So like, we know the quality of that education. So therefore he said like, if I was really a good teacher, I won't be teaching in this university. But on the contrary, I don't think even you are good students. Because if you are good students, he don't have to continue that dialogue. But he meant that if you are good students, you'll be studying in IIT, NIT, or some greater engineering college than coming to PIET. So we laughed a lot, but internally we were feeling guilty that we bunked that university on that particular day. So we came back, and that time I had all long hairs. Like, he asked me to cut short my hairs as well. Not on that day, but like after that lecture. But yeah, so the learning goes somewhere after we cross those hurdles of being a good or a bad teacher. And sometimes there is a range that you'll be offended, or you'll be offending someone to actually learn some stuff. And as a matter of learning is concerned, that's perfectly normal, I would believe. And I don't know how to say that, but like, being the bad student made me good terms with most of my peers. Sorry, being a bad student made me good learner along with my peers as well. So that was a short story for today. See you in next video or next life, whichever is earlier. Ciao.